Hi guys, and welcome to another video. And in this lesson, we're going to be looking at genetic disorders. Now, genetic disorders can be caused by an abnormal gene or an abnormal chromosome. And the two genetic disorders that we're going to focus on in this lesson is cystic fibrosis and polydactyly. But we'll start with cystic fibrosis first. Cystic fibrosis is a genetic disease where the cells in the body produce a thick mucus. And this can particularly cause problems, especially in the lungs, where it makes breathing difficult, or if this happens in the digestive system, it can make the digestion of foods difficult. Now, cystic fibrosis is caused by the recessive allele. So what this means is that you need two of the alleles for the cystic fibrosis disorder. In other words, both parents are carriers. And what this means is that the parents carry the allele for cystic fibrosis, but they won't show any of the symptoms of the disease. For example, let's say we have a mother and a father, and the mum's alleles is capital C and lowercase c, and the dad's alleles is capital C and lowercase c. The capital C stands for the dominant allele, which is a normal, healthy allele, where the lowercase c stands for the recessive cystic fibrosis. The parents in this example won't display any of the symptoms of cystic fibrosis, because you need two alleles, two of the recessive alleles, to have the characteristic. But when this mom and dad reproduce, and we can draw a genetic diagram, that when this mom and dad reproduce, we can find out the probability of their children having cystic fibrosis. So I'll put the dad's alleles at the top, and I will put the mother's alleles at the side. And if this allele and this allele, then we would get capital C. So this child would be classed as healthy. We would get capital C and a lowercase c. So this child would also carry the allele for cystic fibrosis. And this child would also be a carrier. Now this fourth child here, both of their alleles are recessive. That means that this child here will have cystic fibrosis. So there's a 1 in 4 chance, or a 25% probability, that these two parents will have a child that suffers from cystic fibrosis. Remember, this is probability, so every time this mother and father reproduce, there's still a 1 in 4 chance every successful pregnancy. But let's take a look at the second genetic disorder, which is polydactyly. Polydactyly isn't life-threatening. But it's where the child could be born with extra digits. And that just means extra fingers or extra toes. Polydactyly is caused by the dominant allele, which means only one of your parents need to have the allele for you to have the disease. So, I'll do another genetic diagram. If we have a mother and a father, and we use capital H to represent polydactyly, and we'll use lowercase h to represent the healthy allele. So we can see here that the mom carries the allele for polydactyly, so she will have extra fingers or toes. Whereas the dad is recessive. He doesn't carry the allele for polydactyly. But when mum and dad reproduce, again, we can draw a genetic diagram to work out the probability of their child having polydactyly. I'll put the mother's alleles at the top and the father's alleles at the side, and we can fill in our genetic diagram. And when we've filled in our genetic diagram, we can see there is a 50% chance, or a 1 in 2 probability, that this mother and father, that their child will have polydactyly. There's also a 50% chance that their child will not carry the allele for polydactyly. Okay guys, thanks for tuning in, and stay in touch for another video.